Today we're going to open up and tear down the Samsung Gear VR to see what's inside. First off, we have this focus knob on top that will adjust the phone's distance from your face while you're wearing it. And on the side we'll have the back button and the touchpad. And on the bottom we have the charging port that will both power the device and charge your phone when not in use. The Gear VR can also be powered directly from your phone as well, so it does not need to be plugged in to function. The proximity sensor is in between the two lenses on the inside, and that can tell when your face is pressed up against the device. This isn't so much of a repair video because I doubt many replacement parts will be available for this device. It's more to satisfy my own curiosity of how this thing works. If replacement parts do become available, you can bet I will link them down in the video description, just like usual. Let's open it up. There are four screws around the outside shell hidden by rubber caps. Pop those bad boys off, and then two more screws are hidden under this black plastic sticker. When lifting off the faceplate, there is one wire reaching from the phone micro USB port to the main board, so I'll be gentle with that. You can see the focus knob moves each of these five towers to adjust the phone distance from your face. There are three screws holding on the plastic protector over the main board. Then I will unclip the micro USB ribbon just like a little Lego. Now there are 10 screws holding the inner plastic shell in place. Some of these screws are different from the others, so I will keep them all organized as I remove them. I'll also disconnect the touchpad sensor from the main board. Then the whole plastic frame and charging port can lift out of the white shell. The circuit board is adhered to the black plastic, but it can be separated. Here is the back button and the ribbon for the touchpad, and the other ribbon is for the inner proximity sensor. I thought the adjustment system is pretty cool. Each of these little gears sit at the bottom of these little towers and allow them to raise and lower. I guess that's why they call it the Gear VR. I am so funny. The lenses are very secure. I doubt they will ever fall out on their own, even if the headset is dropped a few times. The only way to get them out is to remove this black plastic frame that holds them in place, and then the lens just comes out of the hole. We can inspect the lens. It is made of optical plastic. I got the Samsung Gear VR's little brother here, Google Cardboard. Let's poke his eyes out so you can see both plastic lenses. They have the same relative curvature, but the Gear VR is a bit bigger. Overall, the build quality of the VR headset is pretty solid. There are plenty of screws and everything seems secure. Time will tell. Check the video description for replacement parts and current pricing on the Gear VR and Google Cardboard. Thanks a ton for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe. It is free. I'm going to go ahead and watch you do it. Yeah, it's just right down there below the video. Just hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching.